In this session, we are discussing AVL tree. Before going for AVL tree, let us discuss what are the problems with binary search tree. And for that purpose only, the AVL tree has come. So now, let us suppose one set of data has been given. So this is my set of data. That is 11, 22, 33, 44, 55 and 66. And this data is sorted in the ascending order. So I have been asked to form binary search tree from this set of data. You know how to form a binary search tree from a given set of data? So at first 11 will be taken and that will be the root node. Then 22 will be taken, 22 is greater than 11, so 22 will be the right child of 11. We know the binary search tree. In the previous videos, we have discussed what is a binary search tree, how to do insert, delete, update operations and so on. Please watch them if you don't know what is a binary search tree. Binary search tree is a binary tree and where each and every data item will be unique. There will be no repetition of data items. And for any node, its right subtree will be having data greater than this and the left subtree will be having data greater than the required root node. So that is the logic for the binary search tree. Okay. So now 22 will become the right child of 11, then 33 will come. So 33 is greater than 11, greater than 22. So 33 will be placed here, 44 in this way will be placed here, 55 will be placed here, and 66 will be placed in this way. So this is known as right skewed tree. Because except the leaf node, all the nodes are having right child. So this is known as right skewed tree. If you take this data in the descending order, then what tree we are going to get? If you want to form the binary search tree out of them, if you have the data in the descending order, 66, 55, 44, 33, 22, 11, then obviously I shall be getting left skewed tree. Except the leaf node, all the nodes will have the left child. Let us suppose the data has been given in this way, the set of data. See, let us suppose this is the set of data given to us. 11, 66, 33, 44, 52, 22. Here you see the data items are not sorted, randomly given. Okay, now see, I am forming a binary search tree out of that. 11 will be the root node, 66 will be greater than 11, should be the right child, 33 is greater than 11 but lesser than 66. 44 is greater than 11, lesser than 66, greater than 34, 33. 55, greater than 11, lesser than 66, greater than 33, greater than 44. So now it will be like this. It is greater than this, lesser than this, and also it is coming like this. So in this case, what is happening, you see, the tree is also getting too much longer. The tree is also getting too much longer. The question is coming in the mind, what is the difficulty for that? In our videos, we have told you that in case of binary search tree, the binary search tree has been made for searching operation because these are the key values. So that's why no data should repeat. So against the key values, I'm going to search. So now searching complexity in binary search tree will depend upon the depth of the binary search tree. What is the depth? From the root node to the leaf node, maximum number of nodes falling on the path is known as the depth of the binary search tree. What is the depth of the binary search tree here? It is 6. How many number of data are there? 6. So you see the number of depth, maximum depth is equal to the maximum number of data, that is the number of data in the set. So if you ask me what is the complexity for searching data here, it will be of the order of n. So here what is the depth? Depth is 5, almost equal to 6 here. So here also the searching complexity will be n minus 1, of the order of n. So what is happening if my set of data is given in such a way, that will be given in such a way that the depth of the binary search tree is getting increased, then obviously in those cases, the binary search tree will have huge searching complexity. So what should I do? I should have a remedy. I should have a solution. And the solution name is AVL tree. Against three scientists' name, this AVL word has come. So this AVL tree is a height balanced binary search tree. So height balanced binary search tree is known as the AVL tree. So now what will happen? I can in place of tree, I can also write BST. Height balanced BST is known as the AVL tree. That will be better for us. Okay, now see, what will happen? Let us suppose this is my set of data given. I shall go for AVL tree construction. So AVL tree will try to form a binary search tree with the minimum depth for the given set of data. See, how does it form? So element will be taken at first, and there I shall calculate one factor known as the balance factor. Also known as BF in short. This balance factor means left subtree height minus right subtree height. So that is known as the balance factor. So for 11, the left subtree height is 0 because there is no left subtree, and right subtree height is 0 because there is no right subtree. So 0 minus 0, its balance factor will be 0. When the balance factor will be 0 or say plus 1 or say minus 1, I shall say it is height balanced. Let me go for the other insertions, then that will, that conception will be clear to you. So now I shall go for insertion of 22. So its balance factor is 0, sorry, 0 minus 1, its balance factor is minus 1, and this leaf node will have always the balance factor 0 minus 0 is 0. So its balance factor I have calculated for each and every node. Now I am going to insert 33. So as a binary search tree, so this 33 will be the leaf node. So 0 minus 2, so it will be minus 2. It is 0 minus 1 because the left subtree is not existing. So left subtree height will be 0 and right subtree is having one edge is there. So the right subtree will be having height 1. So 0 minus 1 is minus 1. Whenever you are getting balance factor plus 2 or minus 2, that means it needs some attention from your side. So what I shall do, I am finding this right subtree is heavier than left subtree for 11. So I shall go for a rotation. So rotation will cause the tree like this shape. Still it is a binary search tree, but height has been balanced. So its leaf node will have the balance factor 0, and here it is 1 minus 1. So it will be also 0. Don't get biased. Don't think that after rotation always the balance factor for all the nodes will become 0. So that is not true. Accidentally here we are getting all zeros balance factor. So now we are going to insert 44. So 22 is there, 33 is there, and 11 is there. So 44 is greater than 22, 44 is greater than 33. So it will be the right child of 33. Leaf nodes will have the balance factor 0, 0 minus 1, 1 minus 2. So here there is no node with the balance factor plus 2 or minus 2. That means it is height balanced. That means for this particular set of data, 11, 22, 33, 44, this binary search tree cannot be expressed lesser than this height. Obviously, you see, 11, 33, 11, 22, 33, 44 means we are having 4 data. So first level, level number 0, 1 data can hold. Level number 2, 2 data it can hold. So 3 data. And obviously for the fourth one, level number 2 will be required. Okay, now I am going for this 55. So leaf node will have the balance factor 0, 0 minus 1, 0 minus 2, 1 minus 3. Always remember, this is the cause and this is the effect. So cause has to be eliminated, then the effect will get eliminated automatically. So that will be one rotation. The rotation will be in this way. Why? Because its right side is heavier compared to left. So I shall go for anti-clockwise rotation for that. What will be the shape of the tree in that case? The shape of the tree will be like this. Please calculate the balance factor also. Leaf nodes will have the balance factor 0, 1 minus 1,
1 minus 2.
So this is known as the balance factor I am calculating. Left subtree height minus right subtree height. Okay, so I have inserted. So last one is 66. So let me insert that one also. Okay, so 66 will be inserted as the right child of 55. So it is balance factor is 0, balance factor 0, balance factor 0, leaf nodes. So it is 1 minus, it is 1 minus 3. So it is minus 2. It is 1 minus 2, minus 1, 0 minus 1, minus 1. So it is minus 2. So it needs some attention. So it should have some left rotation. Here, whatever the rotation I have shown you, this is known as single rotation. And that is another kind of rotation, that is the double rotation. We shall discuss the single rotation, double rotation in our next videos. Okay, now see. So 44 will come up, 22 will go down with 11. So here the right child is 55, here the right child is 66. What is 33? Greater than 22, lesser than 44. Greater than 22, lesser than 44. So lesser than 44, greater than 22. So 33 will be coming down here. So leaf nodes will have the balance factor 0. So 0 minus 1, 2 minus 2, there is 1 minus 1. So in this way the balance factor has got calculated. And here you see there is no plus 2 minus 2. That means this tree is height balanced. This tree was not height balanced. It could have expressed with at least one depth minimum. How many depths are there? 4. How many depths are there in this tree? 3. Depths means from the root node to the leaf node, maximum number of nodes on the path. So that is known as the depth. So in this way, I have seen that if I draw the respective binary search tree, it will be something like this. And its searching complexity will be 6. But if I go for height balanced binary search tree known as the AVL tree, then it will be having the depth of 3. So the searching complexity has got reduced. So for this particular tree, for any kind of node searching, I can have maximum three number of searches, not more than that is possible. So that is known as height balanced binary search tree. So here whatever we did the operations or rotations, they are the single rotations. I think you are getting the logic. So in the next videos, we shall discuss what are the different types of rotations and when which rotation will take place. We shall discuss in the next video. Here you have considered only the what is the AVL tree, why should you learn that AVL tree. Thanks for watching this video.